Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to this Kickstart webinar in Greater Manchester. I hope you're all having a lovely day. I think we're expecting a few more people to join, but I think we've got loads of exciting stuff to get through this afternoon. So we can crack on, and then people will join as and when they can. I'll just introduce myself first, and I want to go through a little bit of housekeeping. So I'm Matt Ainsworth, Assistant Director in the Education, Skills and Work Directorate at the Greater Manchester Combined Authority. And with the team, working closely with colleagues at DWP and others, trying to provide some stewardship around the Kickstart programme, trying to ensure that as many young people as possible, as many businesses as possible are supported through what is a fantastic opportunity for them. So before I go through the agenda for today, I just want to just run through a little bit of housekeeping for everyone, if that's okay. So just to remind everyone first of all that today is being recorded. If you can be conscious of that. So if you've got your camera on and you've got your microphone on, can you please turn them both off now, or else you may well be kind of the star feature when this webinar is uploaded onto YouTube, which it will be. So if you could turn your microphone off when you're not speaking, and also keep your camera off, that'd be great. We are going to have a Q&A session today. So no matter when in the proceedings, if it's kind of key points you wanted to raise, just put them in the chat, and we'll try and make sure they get picked up. Later. And when we get to the Q&A session, so the question and answer session later on, if you do want to come in, just so I can kind of manage the proceedings a little bit better, could you please use the hands up function on Microsoft Teams, so we can see you want to come in, and I'll try and make sure everybody gets a chance to speak. And because there's going to be a few people on the call today and in the meeting, you know, just try and be as succinct as possible when speaking, or use the chat function, because we want to make sure we get through as many questions as possible. And the final point, just to kind of reiterate, that today is being recorded, will be shared on the GMCA YouTube channel. So just be conscious of that. And I'm just going to move on to talk through what we're going to cover today. Got a really exciting agenda, loads of stuff to get through. And you know, we're now kind of six months into the Kickstart program, so lots of learning. Both positive and negative, things we can do to improve the program, but also some fantastic case studies, some really good stories about people's lives who have been improved, businesses that have engaged with it. I want to use today as a bit of a catalyst to make sure that we kind of build on from the fantastic foundations that have been put in place, and trying to make this as much of a success as we possibly can in Greater Manchester. Because as you are all well aware, you know, our young people have been really hit hard by COVID, as have many of our businesses. And Kickstart can provide a great opportunity both to get some young people back in work, back on that kind of on that path towards a kind of sustainable livelihood for the future, and also can help many of our businesses also get back on their feet, and as we start to come out of the pandemic, to really start getting the motors on, so that we can get things back to as much as like normal as possible. So we've got quite a few things to kind of to talk through today. So we've got colleagues from Jobs Centre Plus, or DWP in Greater Manchester, Amy and Ian, who are going to give a bit of a reminder of the Kickstart scheme, what it's there to do, what it's there to achieve, and a brief overview of which young people in Greater Manchester are coming forward for Kickstart. So what our kind of universal credit claimant kind of caseload looks like. Then the one part I'm really excited about is the kind of Kickstart experience in Greater Manchester. It'd be fantastic, I think, to hear from both some young people who are now Kickstart employees in Greater Manchester, and also their employers. Have got colleagues from Bolton at Home, from Elysium Training and JD Sports, to talk about it from both the employer perspective, but also I'm really keen to hear from kind of young people themselves. So how they found Kickstart to date. Then we've got an item by Danielle and Karen from Job Centre Plus locally, just about how JCP locally can help support businesses get onto the Kickstart scheme, the role of youth coaches. to talk through some of the kind of details of how the process works, and hopefully answer many of the questions that you'll have around that. And finally, we've got an opportunity for questions and answers. So anything that isn't picked up in the rest of the discussion, we can pick up in a Q&A session at the end. So hopefully plenty to get through today. Hopefully you're all be well engaged. We've got plenty of questions to ask, plenty of comments to put in the chat. And hopefully we'll get some really good learning out of today. And people will leave this thinking, great, there's a role for me in this, in Kickstart, and the things I can do to make this a huge success, which we all want it to be. So without any further ado, I'm going to hand over to Amy and Ian, who'll talk about do that kind of refresher in terms of actually what is Kickstart all about. So I'll hand over to you. Thank you.
Thanks, Matt. Afternoon, everybody. Welcome to our Kickstart webinar. Really pleased that you've been able to join us this afternoon. So I just wanted to provide a little bit of an overview as to the aims of Kickstart. The Kickstart scheme has been underway since September. Many of you have probably heard of it, but we've been doing a lot of work within Greater Manchester with our partners and Matt's team and GMCA just to make it, you know, that really, really good opportunity for the young people in Greater Manchester, but also fit with, you know, the employers and the sectors and the types of jobs that we've got available locally. So the Kickstart scheme was launched in September last year. And this was the government's response to the pandemic under the Plan for Jobs scheme. And the Chancellor announced around £2 billion worth of funding. And so this was available for employers to create new jobs for those young people between the ages of 16 and 24 who are on universal credit and who are likely to be at risk of long-term unemployment. The funding's available to employers for 6 months, and there's no limit on the number of places if you've got jobs available. You can apply for the Kickstart scheme right through till the end of this year, and you can still start employing young people until the 31st of December. And you can receive funding up until June next year if a young person starts their jobs up until the 31st of December this year as well. And there's also some funding available for training and support so that young people on the scheme can get a job in the future. And that's absolutely fundamental. And we found that that's really fundamental, and it makes such a difference for young people if they do receive some employability support or training alongside their 6 month job. And we're seeing where that has been where that's been put together, that some of those young people have now been placed into permanent work, which is just absolutely fantastic. So the guidance has changed slightly. As Matt mentioned, we've kind of learned from feedback over the last few months. So since the introduction of Kickstart, all employers can now either apply for a Kickstart placement directly themselves, or they can work with one of our gateway organisations. And some of our gateway organisations in GM are either locally connected or they're sector specific. And they can provide some tailored support to both yourself and the young people. And in GM, we've got about 40 gateway organisations that we're working with. And we've been doing some really, really good work with those since the start of the scheme. We've also got a team on the call today. So we've got Ian, Danielle, Karen. And these are our Kickstart account managers and some of our work coaches. And they're going to be able to talk you through the application process during the webinar. And we'll also be able to talk through how we can support you with your application, the process for working with your work coaches, how we support those customers into those vacancies, and also the local authorities and other people. So I'm going to hand over to Ian just to talk a little bit more about the funding available.
Thank you, Amy. So Amy's just touched on the fact that you can either apply directly to Kickstart scheme, or you can go through what we call a gateway organisation. So with regards to the specific funding and how it can support you as an employer, once you start a young person, so the young person aged between 16 and 24 in receipt of universal credit, starts with you on the Kickstart scheme on the second day of that young person being in work, then you can apply for the initial grant, which is £1,500. That is then sent to the employer, and you receive that within 10 working days as a standard. The purpose of the £1,500 is to support that young person in the initial transition into work. It could be used for things like purchasing IT. It could support with uniform. If, for example, they were moving into hospitality or into working into a kitchen, it could help with things like chef's knives. So anything that is able to support the young person on their journey in the early stages and throughout that 26-week placement. You will also receive, as part of the 26 weeks, that the wages at national minimum wage up to 25 hours. So there is an expectation that every young person works for 25 hours per week as a minimum. If the employer makes the decision to increase the hours, then it's over to the employer then to make up the difference in the salary. So national minimum wage at 25 hours per week is refunded. Minimum contribution to the pension is also refunded, and any associated employer national insurance contributions. So the wages are all paid retrospectively. So initially the employer pays the wage, and then when that detail comes through from the PAYE system on an RTI feed through to the Universal Credit, it links into the young person's account, and then you are paid then retrospectively on the salary that's been paid. So that is all managed once the initial information has been sent through at the start. With regards to the application itself, it's looked at in three different stages. The initial stage is the spotlight check, which is a Cabinet Office check, and that's really a due diligence check on the employer. So understanding the company's house detail, just making sure that obviously the recent details have been sent through over the last tax year, and just to make sure, really, I suppose, that the funding that's going to come through to you, you're in a position to manage that funding as well. Then the two key elements following the spotlight check is confirming, one, that these are new roles to the business. So it's important that every kickstart vacancy is a new role to the business. So in a way, I suppose, where have you seen a gap? Where have you sat back and you thought it would be great if we had someone who could support with this type of role? And this is an opportunity for you now to bring that into your business and support. So second point is that new role, how you can explain and how you can show that for us and evidence that. And then the third point is that employability support. And this is absolutely key for the young person as they go through the 26 weeks. And we basically need to show how from day one, from that young person joining, we're going to support them all the way through the 26 weeks and then get them in a position, if they're not in a position to stay with yourselves at the end of the 26 weeks, get them ready for their next step into employment. And employability support could be something as straightforward as having a mentor on site where they can link in and they can start to understand the wider picture of the business. It can be things on the exit strategy, making sure they understand actually how you apply for a role in a particular sector. Is LinkedIn the right place to be looking? Is Facebook the place to be looking? Do I need a really niche CV, depending on what the skills are and what I want to move into? So it's ensuring that we've got all them steps covered. We will support with that type of activity. So if you're going into the application stage, we have got support available from the teams that are going to talk to you today, and we'll certainly link in and help you with that application process. Every application goes through gov.uk, unless you're linking with a gateway. And if you're linking with a gateway organisation, they can also assist with that wraparound support, the employability support as well. So they can take that off your hands and manage that if you're only a small business and you're not resourced or haven't got the knowledge to do that. Amy, just back to yourself. You're going to touch on jobs and sectors?
Just to give you a brief overview. So since the start of the scheme, there's been about 120,000 job starts nationally. We're working with quite a lot of new employers that don't traditionally work with the job centre at the moment, and we're seeing that the most popular vacancies for Kickstart at the moment are admin, retail, digital, but we're also working with some employers with other sectors that some of our young people have got the opportunity to get their first step on the career ladder, or try new skills or transfer some skills into other sectors as well. Some of the other organisations that we're working with are from the private sector, the public sector, voluntary sector. And we're also seeing an increase in some opportunities for some of those industries that unfortunately were impacted by the lockdown. So we're currently seeing an increase in opportunities within the hospitality sector and also in the construction sector as well, as some of those opportunities are starting to open up. And we know there's a shortfall in the hospitality sector at the moment, so that's providing some really good opportunities for people. It's a really good opportunity for some of the young people to look at different sectors that they might not have traditionally want to go into, and it's given us an opportunity to work with some of our employers and some of our gateways just to work through some of those sector specific opportunities. And we've been doing some marketplaces, some pre-employment training as well, to kind of support those young people into those placements. And like I mentioned before, we're finding that we've got some employers that have had some really good experiences with the young people, and some of those young people have now been placed into permanent jobs, which is fantastic. But I think, like Matt mentioned at the beginning of the call, some of the stories that we've heard, how these opportunities have changed people's lives for the better, have just been absolutely fantastic. So it's been a really, really good opportunity so far to provide these opportunities for these young people. But what we're really keen to do is engage with more employers within Greater Manchester that can provide some more opportunities. And Ian can just quickly chat through some of the cohort information from our customers. So you can see that, you know, there's still some gaps in some of the sectors that we're not engaging with. And there are some lower number of opportunities in some of the traditional sectors that are still unfortunately being impacted by the pandemic as well. I'll hand back to you, Ian. Thanks.
Yes, Amy, thank you. So yeah, this to be fair is the fun bit for us, because when we start talking about customers and young people and matching into roles, this is where it gets really interesting, and in a way this is where we come into our own and support young people through. So what we do know across Greater Manchester, we've got around 24,000 young people currently claiming Universal Credit who technically are eligible for Kickstart. And I say technically because what we will also do in our local job centres is each work coach will work with every single claimant of Universal Credit, including obviously the young people. And they will make sure that the journey they're on is the right journey for them. So as much as I say we've got 24,000 young people across Greater Manchester on Universal Credit, Kickstart may not necessarily be the right journey for that young person. However, we may get them to a point within their journey where it is the right step for them to progress into. We are aware in certain areas across Greater Manchester, and you may be aware of that from where you're based with regards to your employment. We do have generational unemployment, and Karen will touch on this later. We are aware in certain areas that the parents or the grandparents may have been unemployed, and that's just kind of part of life, and it's difficult to kind of break that mould. So again, within our job centres, our work coaches are looking to support and assist in breaking that mould, so to speak. We have what we call, we class some of our regimes as intensive regimes. So that basically means that the person who's claiming Universal Credit is available and is actively looking for employment. So that's the young person we'll be focusing on, where they've got a claimant commitment in place. We know what it is they're looking to move into, and we will support them into that area of work. Kickstart, again, is quite interesting because we've actually seen lots of sectors and lots of businesses come to DWP, which historically probably wouldn't have spoken to us, and they'll have had the normal recruitment methods, using Indeed or using their own websites. Hospitality, we know for a fact, used Facebook on a regular basis because it worked. So it's been really interesting over the last few months that we've seen different sectors, different companies come in. And the feedback we've had, and you'll get some of that feedback today, I'm sure, has been extremely positive in, one, the calibre of young person that's come through, but two, also just the surprise that we are able and in a position to support and get young people into really good positions with the roles. One of the other key elements for the young person with regards to Kickstart vacancies is the need to have no earnings, so not working at this present time, whether that be part-time or full-time, and also there needs to be a consideration of that there is a risk of long-term unemployment. So it's imperative that the work coach locally understands the young person, and if there is that risk of long-term unemployment, again, that's where we're looking to manoeuvre people into Kickstart positions, and hopefully with your help on the call today, you'll be able to put some Kickstart roles into DWP in the future. DWP work coach will match against the vacancies, and again, Karen will touch on that later, so I won't steal his thunder with regards to that type of information. And the other thing for me just to highlight is recruitment methods. If you think about the diversity across Greater Manchester, if you think about what your normal recruitment is, and you also think about the young people that we're looking to support here. So this is about coming out of the pandemic, and it's obviously impacted on our young people heavily. We've had young people who have made a decision not to go to university. So being in college, made a decision not to go because it's not the same lifestyle, or it didn't feel right last year. Also, young people have been on apprenticeships, and their apprenticeships have been finished just because of the situation and how the pandemic has impacted employers, because the apprenticeships could no longer continue. We've got young people who were with us on Universal Credit who we probably would have moved quite quickly into work. However, obviously their sectors or their roles were impacted quite heavily. So one of the key areas that we talk about a lot is your recruitment method. Have you got an opportunity to change that? Do you normally recruit via a CV? Do you normally recruit via a website which has got lots of knockout factors? If so, if you come into Kickstart, have you got the flexibility to change that? And again, we've seen some amazing examples over the last few months where employers have took that risk. They've gone along for the ride with us. They've changed their recruitment processes. And again, they've now got some really great young people in working for them. So that's conversations we will have with you as you go through your Kickstart journey. And then the last point for me, I suppose, is just to understand the difference across the area. We can recruit right across GM, we can recruit locally, but we can support national vacancies if the home workers, especially in the current world we're in at the moment. So again, it's just to give you a headline detail with regards to that. When I mentioned earlier about the support that we will give you with regards to your application process, it's just popped up on the presentation screen there. So we do have an inbox available if you're interested in moving into Kickstart. Obviously, there's the gov.uk website, which is very detailed. But if you drop your details into the GM Kickstart employer service email address there, one of my team will pick up dialogue with you very quickly, and we'll start talking you through the process in a bit more detail and how we can support you. But we will also populate that into the sidebar as well, just so you've got that details from the chat. Matt, I think that's it for myself and Amy. Thank you.
Great. Thank you. A really comprehensive overview of the Kickstart scheme. I think a really important point that you raised, in that this is a great opportunity to try a different way of bringing new talent into a business. So a different way of recruiting that can potentially bring people into your business who you may not ordinarily have been able to reach. And I think all three of us could probably wax lyrical about how great Kickstart is and the opportunities it creates, and both for the business and for the young person. But I don't think there's anything quite like hearing it straight from the horse's mouth. So I'm absolutely delighted that we've got people on today from Bolton at Home, Elysium Training, JD Sports, and in particular the young people working there, to talk us through how they found Kickstart. So Anna, I'm going to hand over to you, and you're our compare for this session.
I am indeed. Hi everybody, my name's Anna Twells and I'm from the Education Skills and Work Directorate in GMCA. So I'm going to be speaking in turn to each of the three employers, starting with Bolton at Home. So I'm just wondering if Nikki and Ellie, would you be able to switch your cameras and microphones on, please? Hi Nikki.
Hiya.
Hi Ellie, lovely to
see you. Hi Anna.
Hi. So I'm going to start with some questions for Nikki. Would you be able to tell me a little bit about Bolton at Home and also about your role, please?
Absolutely. So Bolton at Home is a registered housing provider, a social landlord. We own and manage about 19,000 properties across Greater Manchester region, going into Lancashire and Cheshire. But predominantly we are based in Bolton. Our primary function and purpose is to provide good quality, safe, affordable accommodation for our customers. But one of the things that's always been really important to us is supporting our customers into work skills and employment. So it is part of the heart of what we do. And the reason that we do that is we do recognise that being employed, being engaged economically active, has a significant impact on people's health and well-being, the self-worth, how they feel about themselves, and also in terms of what that creates. So role models for the children, contributing to the community and the neighbourhood where they live, just being active and engaged member of society. So I work on the employment and enterprise team. So my role has changed due to the pandemic. And prior to COVID, I did work experience for adults. So it was about giving people valuable and meaningful work experience and supporting them into work. So it's my role hasn't changed in totality. It is now working with young people, very similar. So providing that 6 month work experience and the employability support around it. What I would say is, just to echo what's already been said, is that don't be put off if you haven't got the function or the facility to provide that employability support, because the gatekeepers do a fantastic job. There are companies out there that can support you with that.
Great, thank you. So I think you've probably covered this, but what prompted you to take part in the Kickstart scheme and what job roles have you created at Bolton at Home?
Yeah, so I mean, the pandemic, COVID is everywhere at the moment. It's everything that's on the news, it's everywhere you read. And it is significantly affected young people around education and employment. So it's their future. So as a responsible business, not just a landlord, we do have a direct role to play in supporting our customers and young people to develop and grow, to become the citizens of the future. If we don't make an intervention, then there is a risk that our young people could drift from years to come. I believe they're 2.5 times more likely to be affected by COVID, have been laid off or been put on furlough because of it. So it was definitely something worthwhile, and it's something that we definitely wanted to get involved in. In terms of roles, so we've got quite diverse roles. We have got 6 young people with us at the moment. We are going through the recruitment process, and we're looking to recruit up to 20 people. So we've got administration roles, so office-based roles. We've got roles that are in the community, around arts and environment. And we've got roles around garden and grounds maintenance as well, just to name a few.
Fantastic. And how are you supporting your Kickstart postholders once they join you at Bolton at Home?
So we do get involved in the recruitment process from the offset. We have adapted our recruitment process, like Ian said. With the office base, we've done that in terms of CVs, which we don't normally accept. But when we're looking at roles that are not kind of academic based, that are more hands on, we are looking to change that even further with just asking them to let us know if they're interested, and having that conversation with them around why they want the role and making sure that they've got the right skills. And I think that's really important. Because we need to be supporting them whilst they're there for 6 months to get work in the future. So we're not expecting them to come in with all the skills around. They haven't got that work experience. They can't demonstrate what they've done before, but what they can do is tell you why they want that role. So that's been really important. And it has helped with the engagement as well. We've got a really high turnaround in terms of people attending interviews, which I believe has been an issue elsewhere. So having that relationship straight away, I think, would benefit. In terms of the other support, so we do provide in work support, which is where we support them to maintain that job. And that's a specific function that we offer within our organisation anyway. We are providing monthly one-to-ones. So we meet with them each month. talk about the work experience that they've had, what they've been doing, the tasks that they've been doing, and how that then links in to them, to the work that they want to do in the future. So in terms of looking at putting things on the CV, in terms of preparing for an interview, writing the a job application, we're heavily involved in that and supporting them with it. We do goal setting with them initially, so we know exactly what they want out of the opportunity, and that kind of sets the standard of the support that we provide to them. We have luckily got the career and life coaching service as well that we can refer into, so that by the end of it, they'll have all the tools, hopefully, that they'll need to go on into further work. And we will do like a next steps, an exit meeting, so that they've got a plan of what happens next if they're not already in work.
That sounds like you've got a really comprehensive support package there for the young people.
Absolutely.
So, Ellie, I'm going to turn to you now. So what were you doing before Kickstart, first of all?
So before Kickstart, I was I just had my little girl. So I had my little one, and then because I wasn't in employment, I didn't have a maternity leave, I didn't have that fallback. So Kickstart was the best thing that we could do, because, you know, it is really hard, especially if you've just had a child, to try and find that employment that can give you that opportunity. And that's what Kickstart did for me. It gave you that foot in the door, as people say, you know, that step on the ladder. So before Kickstart, I was a mother. So that's what this is now. This is me getting me back into my employment-based role. So away from being a mother, but also having that support in Kickstart.
And what attracted you to the job at Bolton at Home?
I think what attracted me to the job at Bolton at Home was the company, but it was the way that I applied for my job. So we have, because like I said, I'm a mother and she's in school, and I'm a single mother as well. So I need the support that Kickstart offered us. So it isn't just, you know, this isn't any disgrace on any normal job. It isn't just apply for the role and get the job and work for us. Kickstart is, well, you've been out of this a long time. We can help you do this. You can do this, and you can do this, and you can try this. And if it doesn't work, we'll find another way around that. So it wasn't just Bolton at Home has offered a job, because Bolton at Home is an incredible company to work for, but it's also Kickstart managing this role. So you've got this support here available, and you've also got this support available. And that is what which drew me to the application in the first place.
Excellent. And could you tell me a little bit about the job that you're doing with Bolton at Home?
Yeah, so with Bolton at Home, my job role is a repairs contact coordinator, which sounds a lot quite complicated. So because we are a social landlord, we do look after the properties in which our tenants live. So if there is something that has gone wrong, or, you know, something needs fixing or anything like that, especially with the pandemic going on, a lot of our work has been backlogged. So we've had not a lot of time to be like, right, you need to get this all fixed now, you've been off for a year. So that's what we've been doing. We've been basically tackling all of the jobs that you're doing, you know, from elderly residents to young couples that have got new homes for the first time. So it's a really nice role to be able to jump from family to family and see what's going on and fix them up for where they live. It's nice.
It sounds like a really critical role as well, a really important role.
It's a lot of time in front of computers and organizing and coordinating, really, fixing things and stuff like that, and sending out engineers and helping with advice and things like that. It's a very people-y role, and I really like that.
Excellent. And I think you've maybe touched on this, but what difference would you say the Kickstart scheme has made to you?
Oh, it sounds very dramatic, but it is quite life-changing, because it's not just, oh, you've got yourself a job. It's also, like Nikki was touching then, it makes you feel a lot better, because you've got the mental support, because it can be quite, especially because it is based on such young people from age 16, which at 16 I think is quite an impressionable age still. It's still quite a developmental age. So going into full-time employment or part-time employment, the Kickstart role helps that mental health aspect of things as well, because you've got the support and you're not left, you know, to sometimes flounder under a lot of, you know, adult pressures. And I think that's quite vital when it comes to offering that young people who are especially in long-term employment, this is quite vital, because it can be quite overwhelming and things like that. And I think it is genuinely quite vital for, you know, the kickstart. It does change you as a person, because it helps you grow, especially like Nikki was saying then, because she's great. She helps every month without fail, and if we miss it because of an emergency, she will back you up, and she's on the phone like, we'll do this. And you set an end goal, and you can set, you know, things like that, which, but so you're not just working, you're working on yourself as well. And I just think that's incredible.
Fantastic. So I've got one last question for both of you. Start with you, Nikki. So what would you say to employers that are thinking of getting involved in the Kickstart scheme?
It's an absolute no-brainer for me. Get involved. It's a responsibility of any organisation, I think, to support the community, and especially the young people in these circumstances.
Fantastic. And Ellie, what would you say to a young person who's given the opportunity to apply for a Kickstart job?
Do it. And I know it sounds very like we're trying to sell something, but we are, because it is just so worth buying. It will change your life, even if you think, oh, it's just another job and it sounds like an apprenticeship. It isn't. It's going to be fantastic. Just go and do it.
Oh, thank you. Thank you both. So, would you both be able to switch your cameras and mics off? And if I can invite Lee and Billy from Elysium Training to switch their cameras and microphones on, that would be fantastic. Hello both, hi. You're in the office together, I can see there.
Yeah, we are.
So again, same questions. Lee, I'm gonna start with you. Can you introduce yourselves and tell us a little bit about Elysium Training, please?
I can, yeah. Elysium Training are a small training provider based over in Lee in Wigan. We do two things. We do digital skills training for adult learners who are unemployed claiming universal credit. And we also deliver alternative curriculum, alternative provision for young people who are struggling at school with social, emotional and mental health issues.
Fantastic, thank you. And so what prompted you to get involved in the Kickstart scheme?
It's quite different really to Bolton at Home, and I'm sure JD Sports. We're a really small company, we're a micro company, and we had 3 full-time staff, a couple of part-time staff, and we're going through a little bit of growth at the moment. So for us, it was perfect to increase capacity. Obviously, from a business owner's point of view, it's cost-effective as well. And because we're growing with any really small business, as I'm sure you'll appreciate, cash flow can be tight. So this is a great opportunity for us to get Billy and Lucy involved as we grow, and then hopefully they'll grow with us. It seemed too good to be true at first, but no, it's been brilliant for allowing us to grow the company.
What are the job roles that you've created? I know it's 2 at the moment, isn't it?
Correct, yeah. We've got a business administrator and we've got a teaching assistant.
Oh, fantastic. So quite diverse jobs there.
Yeah, saying that though, we've had both girls doing a bit of everything, just so they get a really rounded knowledge of the business and where we are and where we want to go. So Billy was actually helping out in one of the classes yesterday to just see what it is we deliver on the shop floor, so to speak. So yeah, we're going to try and get him involved in as much as we can, really.
And how are you supporting your 2 Kickstart post holders in their jobs?
But obviously, they've got the college course, which is has been really good. In that we had a bit of feedback in that we wanted to include spreadsheets. So I'll use Billy as an example. We wanted Billy to develop her knowledge and understanding of spreadsheets and Microsoft SharePoint, because we've just gone with everything in the cloud. And the college were brilliant. They amended the course. They've thrown some more hours, a slightly different course as well. So there's the college course. Vocationally, as I said, we're getting the girls to do a bit of everything. With us, it's a bit more of informal, but it's sort of your traditional arm around the shoulder and give them a nudge. And it's a bit more informal. So I think we're supporting them both academically, but also in terms of everyday, I suppose you'd call them life skills, wouldn't you?
Yeah, fantastic. So, Billy, on to you. So what were you doing before the Kickstart scheme?
So all my past jobs have been in retail, which I never really saw as a long-term thing. They were always seasonal jobs for me. And then COVID happened and I lost my job around about that same time. So yeah, I was unemployed for a while and then this programme popped up and I thought it would be a great opportunity.
And what interested in you in the job in Elysium training?
I think the first thing that drew me to it was the fact that it was completely different to anything that I've done before. And I was always interested in it. I just never knew how to go about it, how to go applying for this kind of job. And as well, because I've never had this kind of experience before, I thought that I would never get the job anyway, because they always go for people that have had that kind of experience. But yeah, that's what kind of intrigued me about this.
So it's provided an opportunity for you to make a real change there, hasn't it?
Yeah, definitely. Different career path, yeah.
And could you tell me a little bit about what you do in your job on a day-to-day basis?
So I am a business admin. I just assist the team. It's of around 8 people. So whatever they need assistance with, whether it's scanning documents or filling out the contact log, researching for the company, anything like that, anything they need help with, I'll help with, yeah.
Excellent. So what are you hoping for after Kickstart?
Well, I'm hoping to keep on this job with Elysium, but if that doesn't work out, then definitely something similar. I am interested in it, definitely.
Excellent. And so I guess a final question again for both of you. So Lee, what would you say to any employers, and particularly small employers, who are thinking about getting involved in the Kickstart scheme?
I think it's a good scheme. I think it takes a little while with the paperwork. Ultimately, it's government funding, isn't it? So there's a bit of paperwork to do, but that's a small price to pay, I think, for the benefits that it provides for us. So I think it's a fantastic scheme. I'd say go for it. It's a fantastic way of, I suppose you'd say, so I'll try before you buy. So for me, I want Billy and Lucy, and we've actually gone back for a third role, which we've had the nod for. I want them to grow with us. So I'd say go for it. And I think it's a good opportunity both for the learners and it's a massive opportunity for us as a company to grow with the Kickstart project. So yeah, I'd say go for it.
And am I right, just to check, I'm right in thinking that you've accessed the scheme through Wigan Council, who are acting as a gateway organisation. So they've been able to support you as well, haven't they?
They've been brilliant, yeah, been really good. The process there has been great. The applications that we received as well through Job Centre Plus were brilliant. No exaggeration when I say we could have employed 6 people. And the standard, the calibre of young person that we saw was brilliant. And in the end, we ended up selecting purely based on someone who, I suppose you'd say, cut from the same cloth as us. It just felt right. It fit, and it was down to personality. But we had people with degree. We had 2 people with degrees. We had such high caliber candidates.
And so, Billy, a final question for you. So what would you say to any young person who's given the opportunity to apply for a Kickstart job?
Yeah, I would say 100% go for it. Even if it's something that you necessarily wouldn't go for, it's great to step out your comfort zone and try something different. And if you don't end up liking it, then it's always good to develop your skills in the workplace, and it's something to put on your CV as well for further jobs in the future. Yeah.
Fantastic. So thank you both. Would you be okay to switch your cameras and mics off? Can I invite Robin and Ibra from JD Sports to turn theirs on?
Can you see us?
I can indeed. Hi.
Hi, Anna.
Thanks for joining us. Hiya. So I'm going to start with you, Robin. Can you tell me a little bit about JD Sports and also about your role?
Yep. So JD is a global retailer of sports fashion and outdoor wear. You might know us from the high street name JD, but we also own fashion businesses, Scott's, Tasuti, and we've got a massive outdoor area of our business. We go outdoors, Blacks and Millets. So we employ about 60,000 people worldwide, and around 16,000 within the UK. And obviously we have a global presence, Europe, APAC. So my role within the business is a group head of talent. So I look after everything from talent acquisition. I look after global mobility. I look after anything talent mapping, succession planning. But the main important thing in terms of the Kickstart scheme is our early careers and apprenticeships area that I look after. And obviously Kickstart fits really nicely with this.
So what made you want to take part in the Kickstart scheme?
It was a bit of a no-brainer, really. We've previously never had a national relationship with the DWP. So when the scheme came up, because our consumers, that 13 to 24 age, and because different ways of getting people into entry-level careers with JD in a future in retail, whether that be in head office, out in retail, or obviously a distribution centre, we saw Kickstart as a real great opportunity to create that pipeline of young talent coming into roles. And when we did the proposal for our new roles, we based it on wanting to retain 100% of those roles post-placement. So we have over 1,000 roles that we're offering nationally. We piloted with the first 13 in our head office, and we have another 11, I believe, in the DC. I think it's at 11 now. We started off at 4, but now we're up to 11. But as I said, it's over 1,000 roles nationally. And for us, it's creating that pipeline of young talent from young people who have been displaced by COVID, you know, and are at risk of long-term unemployment. So for us, it's an unbelievable opportunity to be a part of that. And in terms of the DWP relationship, Ian Ogden and Danielle have been absolutely critical in terms of that national plan and the local plan with the job centres. And the young people that we've had echoing what previous people have said has been absolutely phenomenal. So it's something that is going to be the most important thing for us this year.
Right. What sort of job roles have you created?
So a range of different job roles. So the pilot group was in head office and predominantly administration roles, but we had roles in HR admin, we had roles in finance, we had roles in our people services team, early careers, and L&D. And then Ibra is one of my Kickstarters for recruitment, so he's on the recruitment team. So head office roles, quite administration based. We then have roles within our DC, so warehouse operative roles at our DC in Rochdale, and we've got 100 of those. And then the national rollout plan, which is just over 1,000 roles out in our retail stores, but that's cross retail. So JD, Scott's, Jasuti, Go Outdoors, Blacks Millet. So we're trying to offer to any young person, no matter what their interests are, whether that be the outdoors, fashion or sports, the opportunity to obviously have that placement with us.
Right. And how are you supporting the young people? I believe you've been working with the Prince's Trust, haven't you, on the scheme?
Yes. So the Prince's Trust have been phenomenal. They offer our wraparound and employability training. So they use some of that 1,500 funding per young person. And what they do is they offer pre-placement support with things like interview skills, webinars prior to them coming to an interview with JD. They also offer one-to-ones, on-placement support, webinars, aspirational guest speakers. And that complements our internal L&D support programme as well. Some of the other things we're doing to support young people is we've tried to tailor initiatives to young people throughout our business for some time now. So things like Money Matters, which is financial training for young people about how to manage a budget. We've obviously got a range of different mental health and wellbeing initiatives in place with our people experience team. We've got employee engagement forums. We've got diversity and inclusion forums. So we try and create a lot of feedback processes for young people, but also try and tailor our people initiatives to young people in our business and make it about them and bespoke for them rather than just assuming that everybody wants the same thing. We also have a lot of careers interventions throughout the placement. So our aim is that all at the end of placement, they'd either convert into an apprenticeship, and we've got different standards using our levy across head office, DC and retail, or they would go into a full-time role with us if an apprenticeship wasn't for them. We offer maths and English functional skills training as well for young people who might not have had access to education at GCSE level. And it's a bit of a prequel for us on apprenticeship. So, it's just we try and put in all the support functions, educating our managers on why it's different to manage a young person, what additional support that they need. And like I say, the DWP have been instrumental, you know, particularly Ian, Danielle and various other people of getting that over the line. And it only kind of has opened my eyes to what we can do post Kickstart with some of other initiatives that the DWP offer about getting other people into jobs. So maybe people with spoke disabilities or people who come from troubled families. So there's lots of things that I feel has kind of kicked off the back of Kickstart as well.
Oh, that's really great to hear. So Ibra, if I could just turn to you, what were you doing before the Kickstart scheme?
So throughout the COVID period, unfortunately, I was unemployed for pretty much a year. Before that, I was just working call centre jobs, worked for companies like Vodafone, Tesco Mobile, worked for Car Finance 24/7. Pretty much just, yeah, it was just when it came to the COVID period, things just turned to a south, really. Didn't really turn out for the best for myself, especially since I just left my job 2 weeks before the first lockdown had hit. And then from there, it just all spiraled downhill, really. But luckily, the Kickstarter scheme came around, turned that around for me.
Brilliant. What attracted you to the role in JD Sports?
Working in HR is always something that stood out for me, especially in recruitment. I've always tried to help people with jobs, help them with this, writing their CVs, applying for things, especially with my age group. A lot of my friends are in uni looking for part-time jobs, but they don't really understand how to write a CV. Since I've got a little bit of experience in it, since I've been doing it since I'm 18, looking for jobs and everything, I like helping people. It's just like something I like to do personally, just help people wherever I can.
And can you tell me a little about your job in terms of what you do on a day-to-day basis?
So on a day-to-day basis, I deal with the recruitment for the North, Northern Ireland and Wales. And that's the recruitment for all the retail, of everything above supervisors. So supervisors, floor managers, store managers, etc.
And what are you hoping for after Kickstart?
Hopefully either moving on to an apprenticeship or even going on full time, whatever sounds best for Robin, and whatever feels like the best thing to do is moving forward.
Excellent.
He's already working full time, Anna. Yeah, we've talked.
Excellent. That was fast moving, wasn't it? Getting up to full time hours. So I guess the same last question for both of you. So Robin, what would you say to any employers who are considering getting involved in Kickstart?
Just do it. You know, once the proposal is in, because that, you know, it is time consuming. But, you know, from the DOP point of view, they're trying to make sure that it's got the right intention behind it. You can support it properly. There's infrastructure there. So I totally get. But once the proposal is in, like I said, because I've never worked with a DWP before, it's been absolutely fantastic. And, you know, maybe I'm, because Ian is spectacular and so is Danielle in terms of this, you know, you're very lucky to be part of, to have them as part of this region, because they've been unbelievable in kind of everything that we've set up. And the national rollout plan, we're offering over 1,000 roles starting over a 3-week period in July, and that's across the UK. So the scale of complexity around the rollout of it is absolutely huge. So I only say just do it. It's it'll make the biggest difference to young people and to your early careers pipeline in the business, because, not sounding cheesy, they are the future really of your workforce.
Yeah, absolutely. So Ibra, what would you say to any young person who's given the opportunity to apply for a Kickstart job?
Yeah, 100%, pretty much is what Robin said. Yeah, just any opportunity you can get, it's a great time for you to try and change career path. Same what I've done now, I've come from sales, call centres, stuff like that, and all of a sudden I'm working in HR, helping recruit. I'm in recruitment now. It's a great opportunity, either just, if you're looking just to change career path and just get back into work, really.
Oh, so thank you both for taking part, and thanks to all our employers for speaking to us. I think it's a resounding get involved in the scheme there from both the employers and the young people. So with that, I'll hand back to you, Matt, so you can introduce the next agenda item.
Great, thanks so much. I don't know about anybody else, but I'm absolutely blown away by those stories. And I'm going to stretch my kind of IT capabilities to the max and try and do a virtual applause. I don't know whether that works or not, but a huge thanks to Nikki, Lee and Robin, and in particular to Ellie, Billy and Ibra. Absolutely inspirational. Like, and a few takeaways for me from that, and I suppose a few things really came through really strongly that perhaps I hadn't appreciated as much, and perhaps others were. And I suppose the first thing was, you know, these are real jobs that you're doing, and, you know, real jobs with responsibilities. So teaching assistant, organizing repairs, the housing, you know, business admin, HR, you know, this is fantastic. And I was really taken by the idea of actually, this is a chance to try something new, gain some experience in a way that may not have been able to before. And what came through really clear as well was that that support that's available to enable you to take that chance and do something new, and also gain some new skills. So For me, that's absolutely, absolutely fantastic. And the other thing was really interesting to hear, you know, it doesn't matter whether you're a, you know, you're a huge employer like JD Sports with 6,000 employees, or a really small local business like Elysium Training. Actually, the program can work really well for you. And so the other couple of things that I think, you know, really came through strongly was just the high caliber of young people coming forward. And I think the point that Robbie made, that, you know, they are the future workforce. And you know, the absolute resounding at the end, which was, this is a no-brainer for businesses to get involved in. And actually, despite this being a government scheme and there is some paperwork, it's still an absolute no-brainer. And from a young person's perspective, just do it and go for it. So just thanks so much. That was truly, truly inspirational. And I hope that more young people and more businesses see the testimonials you've just given. And hopefully they will be the things that make that difference and think, actually, this is something that we can give it a go, because actually it's not just some bureaucrats in government departments telling us it's a good thing to do. These are, you know, real young people and real business owners and workers who are saying, look, it's a great thing to do. So thanks so much for that. So the other thing that came through clearly was the role of DWP in Greater Manchester. And I absolutely agree that we are really lucky to have people like Amy, Ian, Danielle and others who are really putting their all into making this a success in Greater Manchester. I'm going to hand over to Danielle and Karen from DWP Jobs and Sports locally, just to talk through a little bit, you know, what the role is of the district account managers and the youth work coaches, to talk through some of those practicalities, because what's come through clearly is you're making a massive difference in helping to make this scheme a success. So Danielle, Karen, I'm going to hand over to you.
Thank you very much, Matt. Much appreciated. It's been wonderful to hear from the young people who are coming through the Kickstart scheme. We're really starting to see some wonderful outcomes now, which is just amazing. So thank you very much. My name is Danielle Holt. I am a Kickstart account manager, and I also lead on some of our marketing and comms related to Kickstart too. We also have 8 account managers who are attached to some of our job centres across Greater Manchester. And our role is really to support employers throughout that end-to-end journey on the Kickstart scheme. So right from the point that they put their application in to matching some of our wonderful young people to the roles on offer. Now, from an application point of view, you know, I know that there'll be lots of employers on here who will be, you know, after hearing all the wonderful things, will be thinking, right, it's my time. I'm definitely going to create some amazing opportunities within the business and support the scheme. We will absolutely wrap our arms right around you and give you the support that you need. So myself and my team can provide you with some valuable insight into making a quality application. Certainly if, you know, you want to apply directly to the Kickstart scheme. And shortly we will communicate that at the inbox in the sidebar if you do wish to come through us for that additional support. As Ian touched on earlier, you know, that there's lots of different elements that you have to sort of ensure that you cover to make that quality application, including some of that wraparound employability support that you're going to provide throughout the life of that 6 months, and you know, how you're creating new opportunities. So as I say, myself and my team absolutely support with that piece. Once employers have been agreed on the Kickstart scheme, what we do is we work really, really closely with them just to educate on, you know, how to write up their job descriptions. And this is where it's really key for Kickstart. And we've heard a little bit around how employers are being quite flexible at the moment in terms of their application route. At the start, it was very much send a CV, send a cover letter. now what we're seeing is employers are actually removing some of those barriers. Young people will sometimes think, oh, CV, you know, maybe a little bit too much. It might sort of make them feel overwhelmed. Now, employers are actually coming forward and just asking a couple of key questions or having a phone call with the individual just to see what really interests them. So we do just try and support employers in developing that job description, the application route, and everything like that. And from there, I think the important thing to touch on is the engagement with our local job centres. So once the jobs are, you know, live on our universal credit system, what we do is we work with employers to ensure that they're at the forefront really of our work coaches' minds, so that they can sell the vacancies on offer and the roles on offer. But also what we encourage employers to do is go in front of our customers as well and just explain more about their business, their values, help really bring the roles to life. That has been absolutely key activity for us over these last few months. And it certainly supports, you know, in engaging young people. We've had some amazing employers who've had all sorts of, you know, fantastic selling points to their organisations, such as, you know, fantastic breakout areas, games consoles, pool tables. It appeals to young people. So actually, it's, you know, it's definitely worth mentioning. So as I say, we've been really, you know, we really work closely and ensure that our local job centres have that dedicated relationship with the employers that are coming through the Kickstart scheme. But what we also do as well is we really encourage employers at the moment to market their vacancies in the right way. And when I say this, it's about putting together, you know, some nice visuals, perhaps videos of the organisation itself, a sort of a day in the life. And again, this just helps connect our customers to you. But all, you know, also the directive also always has to be to actually engage with their work coach. Not every young person has that great relationship with their work coach. But actually, that's how young people have to apply for these jobs. So, you know, as employers right now, employers are helping sort of solidify those relationships and bring those young people back round to their work coach to talk about the amazing opportunities on offer as well through the scheme. We also link in quite closely with our local authorities. Again, really, really important activity, certainly to increase that that customer engagement. Lots of our local authorities operate employment and skills teams, work and skills teams, and they are, you know, they're talking to our Universal Credit customers through their youth hubs and also on their social platforms. So, you know, as I say, employers are developing a lot of content for us to share there, really, just to market really, you know, give some insight into the opportunities that they do have on offer, which is key, as I say. Our local authorities are actually also helping us with, you know, employers accessing the Kickstart scheme as well. And, you know, sort of supporting all of the comms and good news and all the wonderful outcomes that we're seeing at the moment when as young people step into their Kickstart roles. And this is, it's really helping to sort of increase participation. That we've got lots of employers making direct applications at the moment. Myself and my team, as I said earlier, do support with that. And we're holding weekly webinars, actually, every Tuesday at 11 o'clock. You can join one of those just to go through the application process itself, take away some hints and tips, and then we can support you right through that end-to-end journey. Thank you very much. I'm going to hand over now to Ceron, and he's going to talk about the work coach role and how young people are matched to some of the amazing opportunities that we do have on offer. Thank you.
Hi, my name's Ceron Kumavach. I am based at Earlham. I am one of the youth work coaches. Basically, how I select young people for the Kickstarts is you've got to really speak to them, get to know them a little bit and find out what motivates them, you know, what interests them, you know. You also got to look at some of the social indicators. Have mum and dad, have they been on benefits for a long time? You know, do they have any positive influences within the household that are pushing them forward? Generally, you can find those people who already have that. They don't necessarily need a lot of support to get a job. It's those who don't have that support, that's when they tend to struggle. So what I like to do is get them in, sit them down, find out exactly what they want to do. You know, it could be something as simple as warehouse or retail or even working in the stable. There's a lot of stuff that they can do. And it's just basically just breaking it down to them bit by bit to say, look, you can do whatever you want. I'm here to support you. You know, let's start with, you know, what is that you have? Do you have a CV? A lot of times they don't even have a CV. So not a problem. I'll sit down with them, make sure that that CV is tailored to whatever Kickstarter is that they want to apply for. It's really important that I'm in touch with the employees as well, the guys who are providing the Kickstarter opportunities, that we do have a good working relationship. So I can actually give them a call, say, okay, we've got this person in there. We've got a very, really good candidate, but they're a little bit nervous. So can I just go through a few things, you know, to put them in a good position, so when it comes to the time for the interview, that they can, you know, they can really just flourish and just really crack on, really. There's so much I can really say. A lot of my candidates, they're very, very nervous. They just don't have that practice in terms of interviews or the relevant skills. So we can do mock interviews here. I like doing that with them just to really put them through the paces to show them what they're expecting. And there's so much to it. I've just tried to break it down as simply as possible, really.
Thanks, Ceron. I think we'll hand back to Matt now. Thanks, Matt.
Great. Thanks, Danielle. Thanks, Ceron. I mean, what comes through really, really loud and clear is both the kind of the passion you both have for this. I think the other point is that kind of tailored hands-on support, that you really want this to work for both the young person and the employer. So kind of following on from what Robin and Lee and Nikki said earlier, which was actually, you know, you really do want to make this a success and personally invested in it, which is really good to see and hear. So it's great to have kind of webinars like this where we can actually see that firsthand. So thanks so much for that. Well, we've got some time now for a few kind of questions and answers if there are any. So there's been a stream of kind of comments and questions in the chat, which I kind of I'll touch on some of those. But also, if anybody has a kind of burning question they want to ask, then you know, please feel free, put your hand up, and we can make sure we look to answer that. But before, if nobody has their hand up, I wanted to ask one of the things that came up in both the interviews and also in some of the chat is the role of the gateway. So I don't know whether Ian, are you able to shed a bit more light in terms of what an employer, a small business, could expect from a gateway organisation?
Yeah, absolutely. I know we touched on it, but until you kind of get involved in the scenario, it doesn't really impact, does it? So I suppose there's a couple of route ways with gateways. Gateways obviously will manage the funding. So what that does do, I mean, it was mentioned earlier from the employers that there is definitely paperwork involved, lots of detail with regards to the application process. So what the gateway will do for the employer is they'll take that element away. However, they will be very involved in understanding, is it a new vacancy, what the job vacancy is that's on offer, and obviously how they can support. So the application process will go directly through the gateway. They will do it as part of what we class as a variation. They send the variations in fairly regular. As a minimum, they'll usually send them in once a month. Some of them do them twice a month. And then the offer may vary. So for instance, we've got offers with some of our gateways in Greater Manchester where the offer will be, you receive the full amount of money, as in the £1,500, and you do your recruitment yourself, or they support around the recruitment activity. It may also be that some of the £1,500 is divvied up to support the wraparound support. So the gateway will manage that employability support. They will have one-to-one mentoring, online training available. So it may be £500 is taken from the £1,500 or £750, depending on the agreement with the gateway organisation. And again, they will also support in the background with regards admin. So if there's any follow-up needed done directly with DWP, they will link in directly with DWP and do that. So kind of the third man, really, making sure that everything's ticking over in the background. And that probably covers it in a nutshell, Matt, I would have thought.
No, great, thanks, Ian. Just a follow-up, I suppose, on that. So, you know, if I was a small business, you know, not really knowing where to go, how would I find out about gateway organisations and who to turn to? Is there like a directory or anything? Or
yeah, absolutely. So on our gov.uk Kickstart page, there is lots of detail on there, but it also allows you to view which gateways are available. It also allows you to look at geography, so you can make a decision to look at a gateway in Greater Manchester, which is always our preference because we like to fly the flag, obviously. It also allows you to look nationally and also down to sector. So you may want to work with a gateway who manages a specific sector, for instance. So that's on there. And I'm pretty sure we dropped the link in the sidebar as well earlier. So that detail will be there in the chat for you.
Great. Thanks so much, Ian. One of the other things that's in there that's been mentioned in the chat a couple of times, I'm going to bring Robin in for this, is that the Kickstart itself is a kind of fixed real job, but there are pathways from Kickstart into other opportunities, so be they full time jobs or and I think you've talked about apprenticeship opportunities in JD Sport. Could you explain a little bit how that works from your perspective?
Yeah, of course. I mean, we're £1 million levy payer, so we want to make sure we reinvest that money into what it's there for, into obviously in the improvement and development of people at all levels. So specifically our apprenticeships are across all levels, so whether it's somebody who has got no education whatsoever and we would work with them on the maths and English functional skills if they haven't done that as a prequel to apprenticeship, and they then go on to whatever apprenticeship standard is within their area, so or area of interest. So for example, we have apprenticeships in retail, which are retail management and retail level apprenticeships. We have the same in the warehouse, but we also have specialist ones as well. So in finance, the Kickstart admin person who we've recruited in finance, they will have the option to go and do the AAT qualification via the levy. So that would give them a financial qualification at the end of it. But also we see it as very, apprenticeships is very much a retention tool. So not only are we offering this person a full-time position, but they're on the apprenticeship for 2 years. And in that 2 years, they can be promoted, they can have salary reviews, they can go into different areas of the business, and they'll also get this externally recognised qualification at the end of it. So we use a bulk provider for apprenticeships called Cube. They're our main provider for retail and warehouse. But then we have around 15, 16 specialist providers across finance, HR, buying, merchandising. There's that many that we have. So in each head office area, there's apprenticeship pathways, whether you're an internal person and it's offering you additional development, or whether we recruit apprentices into those roles. So Kickstart for us, we plan on converting all 1,228 that are roles signed off into apprenticeships in the area that they're in, or the offer of obviously a permanent role, because apprenticeships aren't for everybody. Not, you know, you have to want to do it because it is a development, but absolutely it's something that we'll offer across the board. And we have an entire apprenticeships team who can manage that process as well.
No, that's great, Andrew. And we're all keen to ensure that, you know, Kickstart itself is a great opportunity for 6 months, but really what we want to see is that being that springboard into a a career, a career for the future, and apprenticeship is a great, is a great opportunity to do that. So it would be great for us to be able to reference the work you're doing at JD Sports and get other businesses thinking about, you know, how they can, how they can link Kickstart into other progression routes like apprenticeships. That'll be, thank you so much. And I'm just going to post something in the chat, because I know that it can be quite difficult for people to understand what apprenticeships are available and how to access them. And there's a website that called GMAX, which has been developed to try and make people make young people aware of what opportunities are available. And I think there are also opportunities for levy paying organisations to transfer some of their funding available to other businesses that they can make use of the system. I know it can be quite complicated. So I don't know. I think, I'm sure a colleague of mine, Nick's in the audience today, might be able to post something in the chat about how we can some information on that if anybody's interested in kind of levy matchmaking support. Now, I can't see any. Fantastic, Nick. Straight away. So have a look through that as well, because there are opportunities for other businesses to get involved in apprenticeships, which is brilliant. I can't see any other hands up, and Matt, it looks. Sorry, Anna.
We've got two hands up. So we've got a Matthew Carter with his hand up, and then me.
Okay, great. There's something obviously going wrong on my screen. So I'll bring Matthew in first.
Hello. Yeah. Afternoon.
Hi, Matthew.
Yeah. Just sort of like you, and sort of give the viewers, you was mentioned about the gateway as a sort of gateway provider, but also we've employed some kickstarts, and we've also got some people working together as well with the kickstart. We're waiting for some more people to join. Yeah, we work in Manchester. We work very much with the JCP, very much on employability training. So we do a lot of courses, work skills, and the CCS. So that's why we started as a kickstart gateway. Just sort of like that support we offer to employers is work, and what we've got, the success stories so far at the moment, a lot of small employers have found the gateway very useful, because it's, and we can answer those questions where they can't, they've not got that information, especially on things like contracts, and sort of like some have never done that before, have employed anybody before, so it's been, they've been very useful and helpful that way. But also that links we've got with the JCPs that's worked really successful. I mean, one thing, I definitely attended the meeting yesterday, the drop-in centre yesterday for all the young people. I thought that was a brilliant idea, and I'm definitely, because we're going to be working with a big employer in Manchester that's offering 50 positions. So I'm definitely suggest to him and ourselves attending that to get that out to the young people. But also the one thing that we, our ethos ESP is basically, is to support the employer, but the young person, and look at the whole picture, so the whole journey, and sort of aim them to an apprenticeship at the end. And being an apprenticeship provider, it's that seamless link that we can sort of like either start on one of our apprenticeship schemes, but also if it's something that we don't cover, we can then put them in touch with a provider that can. So it helps that way, and it takes away all the sort of like juggling around and making it an easy ride for that employer, especially the small ones, but also even the large employers as well. You know, we're working with some large national employers, but the smalls, we're having some good success stories with small employers that way. And one of the things as well, it's that support taking away a lot of the paperwork from them and sort of the monitoring, because we do monthly reviews and check on their spend for the grant, which the DWP need to know. And we've made it an easy streamlined service for that.
That's great. No, yeah. Thanks, Matthew. I think you kind of reiterated the point, you know, that the real benefits that gateway organisations can play for businesses, both large and small, in terms of both kind of simplifying the process and system, providing that support, and finding those kind of pathways and routeways into other opportunities. There's a question that Hannah's just put in the chat about, also quite a good question, you know, how do people find out about Kickstart vacancies? So I don't know whether Ian or Amy are able to help with this one. Is it just through work coaches, or can you find out about job opportunities elsewhere?
So the vacancies land on our internal platform. So our platform also has every young person, or every person actually, who's on Universal Credit, and then we're able to match across through conversation. There is also other ways in which you can find, so the detail that was touched on during the walkthrough there, especially around the marketing activity. We have a lot of activity with our employers around LinkedIn or around Twitter. So there's lots of social media activity. However, when we do that, it always has to revert back to a conversation with the work coach. So you won't see Kickstart vacancies landing on job boards, the likes of Indeed. You won't see them landing on employer websites to complete the application form or to progress through to interview. It always has to come back into the job centre and the work coach conversation. And there's a key reason for that. We need to make sure it's the right journey for the young person and also that they're eligible with regards to the funding. So yeah, it varies. We very quickly realised that it's the right thing to allow employers to advertise and show, I suppose, their brand. We just need to make sure that we manage it internally with that conversation. And Matthew's just touched on there one of the sessions that we've done yesterday. So we do invite employers to our marketplaces. We're doing our first jobs fair, a virtual jobs fair in Manchester next week, which will probably focus more on central Manchester Kickstart vacancies. But we have employers coming in now daily to our marketplace conversations, supporting with the vacancies and actually meeting the young people virtually as well. So that's the main way we do it.
Great, thanks, Ian. So employers can't kind of advertise their and manage their recruitment that themselves and advertise it. It's all through the work coach, and we saw through Karen the reason why that is, and the kind of the relationship that the work coach has with the young person and the employer. But we can use events like the one referenced yesterday and events like today, I suppose, to make people aware of the types of jobs that are available and advertise them that way, rather than being kind of, as you said, adverts on job boards. So, okay, great. Thanks for that. Anna.
Yeah, just one question from me that I'm really asking on behalf of employers who might be new to Kickstart, and it's a question that I think Ian or Amy might be able to respond to, that if I put in an application for grant funding, and that might be as an employer, it might be through a gateway, what sort of timescale are we looking at for that to get approved? And then once that grant application has been approved and we need to get things up and live in Job Centre Plus, what sort of time scale are we looking at? And I'm really asking this question just to sort of help manage expectations for employers new to the scheme.
Yeah, so our expectation would be from the point that the button is pressed on gov.uk or the variation goes through the gateway, our expectation would be to turn that round in within the month, the 31 day. At the point we get to that, if we get to that, then we would escalate that so that the team across Greater Manchester would then look to get involved nationally and just understand why there's been a delay, if there's been a delay. In general, they're turned around much quicker than 31 days. However, as I say, the SLA is to stick to that 1 month window. And then following that, just to give a bit more detail, because I know, Anna, we had a conversation earlier with regards to GMCA specifically, you then send your job placement details into us. We upload that onto the system, and again there's an expectation there that we'll upload that within a 10-day window, and then at that point we're doing recruitment. So if you're thinking backwards, then you need probably a 6-week lead in there just to make sure you're at the point where you're ready for interview. Is that okay?
Yeah, thanks Ian.
Okay, thanks. Well, I can't see any more hands up, and I think all the questions and points that have been raised in the chat have been responded to. So in which case I'm going to draw this to a close. I'd just like to finish with some thanks. So thanks to Anna, Lucia, and the team for organising today's session. Now, a huge thanks to all of our speakers today. Some really inspirational stories as well, and really getting into the kind of how the programme works in practice is really good. And thanks to all attendees and for your input and questions. So thank you so much, and look forward to seeing you all soon.